everyone, Marine here for Landfun. Thanks for joining me today for this new video featuring a lovely rainbow treehouse. Here's a quick look at all the sets I used. For the dies, the Magic Iris and add-on, the Burnhouse add-on, a Puffy Cloud border, and the biggest die from large stitch rectangle stackables. And for the stem sets, special delivery for the envelope, screen time for the two characters, cheery Christmas for the ladder, bicycle built for you for the cheese, bread and wine, crazy antics for the basket and watermelon, O gnome for the lantern and present, critters in the jungle for the flower, hey there for the small bow, wild for you for the butterfly, and finally wood grain backdrops. And just a quick note, my apologies because it's pouring rain outside, so you might hear it in the back. So as always, I started with the coloring. I stamped my images using jet black ink, used the coordinating dies to cut them all, and used my spectrum markers and graphite brush markers to color everything. Thank you. Once the images were done, I moved on to the background and started by cutting the main panel as well as the arrow handle out of paperback cardstock. I kept the elements together by using washi tape at the back and placed the panel in my Misty tool. I put the wood grain backdrop stamp on one half and stamped it using crunchy leaf ink. And I stamped it twice to get a very nice impression. I flipped my panel upside down and placed the stamp on the other half and did the same thing. I stamped the wood texture twice using crunchy leaf. And once my panel was all covered with wood texture, I applied a little bit of vintage photo distress ink on the edges, nothing more. Next, I cut the house out of a rainbow paper from Really Rainbow. And I chose this paper in particular because it looks like wood planks that have been painted, maybe by my two characters. But it definitely needed wood texture, but a different one from the background, so I used the stitched wood grain backdrop die to get what I wanted. Next, I cut the roof and the floor out of paperback cardstock and applied vintage photo distress ink on those pieces as well, just like the background. And next, I moved on to the magic iris. I cut three rings and two tabs out of paperback cardstock, three sausages out of chocolate bar cardstock, and three stabilizers out of scrap paper. I kept one of the rings and used the flux capacitor die to cut three holes and three stitch brackets out of it. And next, I put each sausage piece into a hole like so, and I like to keep those elements in place using clothespins. Next, the sausage die created an X mark on the rounded edges of the three sausages, and this is where I added a glue dot, one glue dot on each X mark. I took a second ring and placed it on top of the sausages. I pressed firmly to connect the different elements, and I turned the ring over to apply double-sided tape on the three stitch bracket spots. Next, I turned the ring over again and attached my two tabs together. I like to use two tabs to get a more sturdy element, something that won't bend when I use it. So I attached this sturdy tab at the right side of a stabilizer, and I applied double-sided tape on the stabilizers. I removed the backing paper, placed the last ring on top, made sure that everything was lined up, and folded the stabilizers to finish the magic iris. Next, I took the arrow handle from the beginning of the video and attached it on the tab right up against the ring. I trimmed off the piece of tab that was peeking out. I applied double-sided tape all over the front of the ring, and pressed my panel on top, making sure to line up both the tab and the circle in the middle. Next, I started to assemble some pieces, starting with the house. I didn't want it to be too flat on the background, so I cut two more houses out of paperback cardstock, and I layered my three houses using double-sided tape and liquid glue. And then I attached my rainbow house on the panel. I did the same thing for the roof and floor. I cut additional pieces to get dimension and layered those elements and then glued them on the rainbow house. Next, my tree needed some foliage, so I used the main die from the Magic Iris add-on again to cut a green panel and used a puffy cloud border die to cut three foliage pieces out of this green panel. I applied a bunch of foam squares at the back of each element and stuck them on my panel. Next, I cut a 5.5 by 4.25 inches card base out of paperback cardstock. I stuck a yellow pattern paper on top and temporarily taped the treehouse panel on top and I stuck my wood texture circle right in the middle. Next, I placed my panel in my Misty tool. I put the basket on the house just as a guide to help me place my sentiment. I removed the treehouse panel and stamped me plus you and a heart below it using vintage photo oxide ink. This way, it looks like it was carved in the tree. I stamped it twice. I applied double-sided tape on the stabilizers at the back of the magic iris, as well as foam tape all around it. And I stuck my panel on the card base. And finally, I attached my images using foam squares and liquid glue. The last thing I wanted to add was a ladder, and I first thought of using the stamped image, but I changed my mind and decided to cut three ladders using the coordinating die. I stuck the three elements on top of each other, applied a little bit of vintage photo on it, trimmed off the bottom, and attached it behind the foliage. And the last final thing, I cut the arrow out of guava cardstock and attached it on the handle. And that's it, a sweet Valentine picnic up in the treehouse, and apparently it's time to exchange some presents. Thank you so much for watching, have a very nice day, and see you next time. Bye!